Thank you for tuning into Beenie TV. So today I want to talk to you guys about a personal topic, and I want to discuss why I am single and why I've been single since I was 16. So that's almost 10 years. I haven't had a boyfriend or So one of the reasons why I am single today one of the reasons why I'm single today is because I still have a lot of self-love to achieve. I still have a lot of self-love that I want to have for myself, and I still want to enjoy myself as I am today. For so long, I was just really, really angry and really, like, negative mindset and really, like, depressed and just not happy with myself physically, not happy with where my life was going. And I've finally come out of that dark place. And now that I enjoy myself, I want to fully enjoy myself and be by myself and really get to know this new Abina, you know, and nothing wrong with bringing a guy into my life to enjoy me with me, but I just want to spend some more time with myself. Last year, I really wanted a boyfriend. I wanted a boyfriend so bad. And I think it was because, you know, I just moved to Los Angeles and I was like lonely and, you know, in an uncomfortable place. And I really wanted someone. And then I realized, no. And another reason why I'm single is because I'm confused. I don't know what I want. I don't know when I want it. Like, I want someone who, you know, loves himself. I want someone who respects himself I want someone who respects himself and respects his life, his family, someone who is spiritual, someone who loves God, someone who knows that they are a living God, someone who has their career together or their career like starting to really like take off. I want someone who is financially blessed, abundant, and likes to share those financial blessings, you know. And for so long I dated like these like hood dudes, like these drug dealers, these rappers, these like or the really, really nice guy who I have nothing in common with. You know, like, that was what I've been dating for the past 10 years. And I don't know what I want. And you have to be clear on what you want in order to receive it. You have to be clear. So until I'm clear, until I'm ready to really get down on my knees and pray to God for the man that he has created for me, then I'm chilling. Another reason why I'm single is because for a long time, I just couldn't accept the fact that a man has to go through a life process just like women. Like, I think women were so hard on men. Like, we want them to be, you know, you gotta be this right now. You are not allowed to mess up. You are not allowed to make any mistakes or have any flaws. And I think that's why I messed up a lot. I wasn't allowing the men that were coming into my life to be humans. And it's like, I mess up. I am going through a process and a progress. Like, why can't they? And that's something that I'm, you know, realizing. And it's like when I get into a relationship or a situationship, it's like I really, really want it. And then when I'm in it, I'm like, this is stupid. I don't want you, like, stop breathing on me. Get away from me, like, right now. Like, that's the other thing is, like, I'm constantly, like, in a wobble. I don't know, like, what that is. It could be from just, like, maybe not having a dad in my life. But I don't want to use that as an excuse because my dad was an amazing dad who really, really loved me, and because of unfortunate situations, like, you know, he's not in my life. But, like, I don't know, I think maybe also the absence of a parent's love, a parent's affection, a parent physically being there has an effect on you regardless. And I think that's why I'm able to just cut people out of my life so quickly, maybe because of the absence of one parent. Like, if you do something to me that I would like never do to you, like, I'm cutting you off, and with no explanation, I will just creep out your life forever, and I will not hit you up, I will not hit you up on Instagram, nothing. And I think that could be the absence of another parent. But I'm learning a lot about relationships when I'm not in one, and then when I'm in one, it is so tough to practice what I've learned. Like, with the Don Miguel Ruiz book, The Mastery of Love, I learned so much about how I don't even know why I want what I want, you know, and how I'm just so not accepting of what kind of men come into my life, you know, and it's just, yeah, it's just one, for me, it's just like, okay, society says you have to be with this type of man. And, you know, watching Love and Hip Hop, watching Basketball Wives, you're thinking, you're constantly seeing that image portrayed to you, and you're just like, yeah, okay, I want that. I want a guy like that. I want a guy like that. But then when you get a guy like that, it's like, it doesn't even go with you, because you need to find out personally what works for you. And as I stated before, you know, as I stated previously, like, those are the qualities I'm looking for in a boyfriend, and like, as time goes on, I will get clearer, but until then, if I'm not clear, the men that are coming into my life won't be clear either, and they will be wibbly wobbly, because I'm wibbly wobbly, you know. And I think I'm also single because I've been in like a situationship for situationship almost for 10 years, situationship for like 7 or 6 years, but friends for 10 years. And I believe that sometimes it can block me from receiving a new guy, my situationship. And I've gotten out of that. Like, I want to get out of that, because it's a comfort, you know. You know that person, you know that person's family, you know how they are, you know how, like, what they're gonna do, like, you know them, and it's a comfortable thing. And at this point in my life, I don't want to be comfortable. I want to really, really expand in all areas of my life, and my love ships need to expand. And I think that's one of the main reasons, is like, kind of comparing everyone to that person. And but also, it's like, when I was in my situationship, it was always just something wrong, because it's a situationship. It's not like a perfect thing, you know. And I believe that I'm also single because I'm just not 100% accepting. As I said before, I can be really hard on men, and I think that that's something that, as women, we do. I think that's something that society has taught us to do. Like, we are perfect, they suck, they need to fix themselves, we don't need to do a damn thing. And it's messed up, and it's stupid. And yeah, I'm I want to focus on my career. I want to put all my energy into my career, and I want to put all my energy into having a deeper relationship with God, and being in a committed an adult relationship. That takes work, and that takes energy, and for now, can't do it. I really, really cannot do it right now. And just, yeah, so, what am I? I'm 25. I've never really been in an adult relationship. I've never been in love, and the last time someone called me their girlfriend, which was not in a situationship, was when I was 16. But these aren't things to be sad about. These aren't things to be like, oh, woe is me, nobody wants me. No, I can get a dude, okay? So trust me. But, like, do I want what I'm asking for? Do I want that deep, committed relationship that is filled with love and God and blessings? And, like, do I want that right now? Yeah, so until I get clear on what I want, I'm happy, I'm joyful, I'm discovering myself, and I'm grateful that at 25, I am discovering myself, I'm discovering God, I'm discovering life, and I feel like so open, and I'm letting go of so many old things that were holding me back, old fears and beliefs and all that nonsense, and the way that I would treat people. Like, that's another thing, probably why I'm single, is that I don't know, like, I can do loving things, but like sometimes when I speak, it's it gets ugly, and I have to learn how to speak respectfully to the people that care about me, to the people I care about. But it takes time. That all of that takes time, and that's what's so amazing about life, is that like we have time to accept ourselves, to be compassionate with ourselves, and not be hard on ourselves. Like, I remember when I was in my teens and early 20s, I was like so desperate for someone to love me, so desperate for someone to validate me, accept me, like kiss me, be all up on me. And what a blessing, and I'm so grateful that I'm not in that place anymore, you know. And if you are still in that place, like, you gotta get out of it, because nothing good comes of it. Like, I don't know how many things have happened to me because I was trying to seek validation with a man, and you know, I'm grateful to be here today, because to think about that mindset that I was in, even just like 4 years ago, the mindset that I was in, it does nothing for you. It does nothing for you. You gotta get out of that mindset, and you gotta just be determined and courageous to say, hey, I don't wanna feel like this anymore. And then you just like work on stop feeling like that, you know? But, yeah, I think those are the reasons why I'm single. And the main one, like I said, is I'm just, like, I'm confused on what I want or what I'm looking for, kind of. But I also know that I'm not ready to be in a relationship right now. I could have fun with you, though. We can have fun. We can have safe fun. But being in a relationship, not right now. And that's okay. I thank you guys for tuning into Beenie TV. It's like not easy talking about personal stuff, and it's really hard not mentioning names. So give me some slack with this. I think this is one of the first times I've really spoken about a pretty personal thing, I think. But anyway, I hope that this helps somebody. I hope this awakens something in someone, because that's what we're all here to do. We're all here to help each other, awaken each other, and get the ball rolling on raising our consciousness and raising our awareness. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter at BeenieTV. Make sure to subscribe, share, comment.